they will have many ways around. And in this session, I'm going to talk about digital signature and electronic signature. So signature is used to pinpoint the signer. It's a proof of his personal attention for the document he signed and to incur some legal rights, duties and liabilities. It is used. In the past, when technology was not advanced, business transactions, contracts were carried out in offline media. But with the advancement of technology, contracts, business are now being conducted in online media as well. But the problem was how to sign an electronic document or a digital transaction. Here, the need for some suitable technology was felt that can work in the similar fashion as it was working in offline medium. It is with this technology that evolved is termed as digital signature. So a digital signature differs from a handwritten or a physical signature. It is unique and different every time it is created and is related to the electronic document it is signing. It is created by using a mathematical process on an electronic document that is being signed that produces a unique numerical value. Numeric value generated by way of mathematic process is encrypted by using a private key of the sender, also known as originator, and the result linked to the electronic document that was signed. So to create a digital signature, signer is required to generate or buy a key pair. Now, according to section 2.1 subsection, so clause X of the Information Technology Act, a key pair is basically found in an asymmetric crypto system, means a private key and its mathematically related public key, which are so related that the public key can verify a digital signature created by the private key. So the intention was to use a trustworthy technology that makes digital transaction legally binding. Now in India, the Information Technology Act 2000 has facilitated the development of digital signature regime. Functional equivalent of handwritten physical signature was developed through digital signature. In cyberspace, the basic legal definition of function of a signatures are performed by way of method that identify the sender, that is originator, of an electronic record. Now in previous sessions, I have talked about electronic record, but just to revise the context and the section of IT Act, it is section 2, subsection 1, clause T of Information Technology Act defines electronic record as a means of data record or data generated, image or sound record, stored, received or sent in an electronic form on microfilm or computer generated microfiber. So electronic record to confirm that the sender approved the content of the electronic record. Any attempt to change the content of the record must be seen to be incompatible with the signature. It is technology specific act that accept digital signature. So if you look section 2.1p of the Information Technology Act, a digital signature means authentication of any electronic record by a subscriber by means of an electronic method or procedure in accordance with the provisions of section 3. Section 3 of the Act enumerates the whole process of digital signature creation and its verification. It is important that the following provisions of the Act should be read and understood along with Rule 3. The manner in which information be authenticated by means of digital signature. Rule 4, creation of digital signature. Rule 5, verification of digital signature. Rule 6, standards of the Information Technology Certifying Authority Rules 2000. Section 5 of Information Technology Act provides legal recognition to the use of electronic signature. Now, what is the technology behind digital signature? So it is public key infrastructure that is also called PKI. It is this which is the technology working behind the system of digital signature. Digital signature is based upon public infrastructure that allows you to transfer your data or documents securely and secretly over an untrusted channel with the use of public and private key pair obtained through an authority. PKI also performs administrative work for digital signature certificates that involves generating, issuing, maintaining and revoking of public key certificates. PKI is a trust model that broadly covers two approaches, hierarchical approach and mesh or cross certification approach. So what is hierarchical approach? So hierarchical approach, in this approach, trust starts from root CA, that is controller of certifying authority, then it flows down to end entities, that is users through a chain of certifying authorities. So basically, first comes controller of certifying authority, then it goes to controller certifying authority 1, goes to certifying authority 2, and with certifying authority 2, it goes to certifying authority 3 and 4, and all of certifying authorities get to the end entity, that is the users. This is hierarchical approach. Now one more approach is there, that is cross certification approach. So in this approach, the trust flows from the root certifying authority of different networks. Now suppose we had two networks, network 1 which is of India and network 2 which is of Japan. If root CA, that is certifying authority of network 1, wants to cross certify the network 2, then it will communicate to the root certifying authority of network 2 and vice versa. In simple words, cross certification is a process which is enabled between root certifying authorities of two or more countries. So what is digital signature then? Digital signature then is nothing but a block of data that may consist of alphabets, numerics, special character or mixture of all. So digital signature technology uses asymmetric crypto information system for the authentication purposes as stated under Section 3 of the Information Technology Act. So what does it say? Subscriber in whose name electronic signature certificate has been issued may authenticate electronic record by way of affixing digital signature. Now authentication process must involve use of asymmetric crypto information and hash function. Now what is hash function? Hash function is an algorithm that maps or translates one set of bits into another, which is generally smaller, set in such a way that a message yields the same results every time the algorithm is executed using the same message as input. And it is computationally infeasible for a message to be derived or reconstituted from the result produced by the algorithm. A public key and private key is a unique pair associated with the subscriber, and any person may verify the electronic record by making use of public key of the subscriber. Now with this, let us try to understand a symmetric crypto system. It is defined under Section 21F under Information Technology Act as a system of secure key pair consisting of private key for creating a digital signature and public key to verify the digital signature. Now asymmetric key cryptography has various advantages. Firstly, you need not to share your key in advance. The only key that you need to share with other party is your public key. Secondly, only the party which is creating the digital signature needs to secure the key. So in digital signature, there are various terminologies involved, and let me make you aware to these terminology, then I will let you know how it works. So the first term is encryption. Encryption is a technique by which a plain text is converted into cipher text. So basically it's a coding. So encryption is basically coding, where you code something in mysterious ways. Now comes decryption. So decryption is a technique by which ciphertext is converted into plain text. But decryption is decoding. So whatever you have coded in encryption, in the process of decryption, you decode it. Now comes private key. प्राइवेट की एज अ टोल्ड फाउंड अंडर सेक्शन 21Z जेड सी ऑफ आईटी एक्ट विच मीन्स अ की ऑफ की पेयर यूज्ड बाय यूज्ड टू क्रिएट अ डिजिटल सिग्नेचर पब्लिक की ऑब्वियसली दी अदर की इन द की पेयर वेरीफाई डिजिटल सिग्नेचर एंड लिस्टेड इन डिजिटल सिग्नेचर सर्टिफिकेट Welcome signer, one who creates digital signature, recipients, one who verifies the signature, hash function is a mathematical function. So how does it work? So if a sender A wants to send a document to B and wish to authenticate that electronic document by the use of digital signature, then A will perform certain functions. Firstly, A will generate a hash value by applying hash function. On electronic document, then A will encrypt the hash value, which is private key. An encrypted hash value is known as digital signature. Now A will append digital signature with the electronic document and send it to recipient B. Now this is all creation of digital signature, and this is all encryption. Now comes the decryption part of digital signature. So Now B receives the digital signature along with electronic document. Now B will generate hash value by applying hash function on the electronic document received in the original form. Now then B will decrypt the digital signature by applying A's, that is sender's public key, and recovers the hash value that was calculated by A. Now if both hash values obtained in first steps are same, then received document is authenticated. That is, it was sent by A only and was not tampered during transit. Now, who all use digital signature? Now, digital signature is considered a very powerful as powerful as handwritten signature and widely adopted as well. Now, it is used as a tool that increases accountability and control in paperless process. Now, nowadays, individuals, banks, government bodies, private organizations, and whoever operating online medium making use of digital signature. So, to achieve authenticity, integrity, and non-repudiation of electronic document is a major concern in online environment. So, what is integrity? Integrity is when your content that you are sending is non-compromised. Authenticity, that your document has not been tampered with. Wrong repudiation, again, nobody has tampered or denied or played with your content during the transit. So this is all about digital signature. Now let me tell you something about classes of the digital signature certificate. When you acquire digital signature, you also acquire a digital signature certificate. Now, digital signatures certificate are classified into four classes. Now, class 0. Now, digital certificates under this class shall be issued for test purpose or for the demonstration purpose only, not otherwise. Now, class 1. Class 1 under this class, digital certificate do not hold any legal recognition, but they are considered valid on the basis of valid email, not on the direct verification. These certificates shall be issued to private subscriber and individuals. Now comes class 2. Class 2 digital signature certificate under this class, it can be issued for both private individuals as well as for business personnel. And this class has a pre-verified database and which is used to verify the identity of the person. Now comes class 3. So this is top class certificate, and these are high assured certificates that are preliminary projected for electronic commerce applications, and this class of certificate will be issued to individuals as well as to organizations. This class requires personal verification, means person need to present himself before registration authority to prove his identity. Now how electronic signature is different from digital signature? Technically, there is no difference between a digital signature and an electronic signature. However, digital signature is a subset of electronic signature. Both perform the same function, signer authentication, message integrity, and non-repudiation. The IT Act 2000, in order to maintain continuity with the regime of digital signature, has introduced the electronic signature. Now, example of electronic signature may include biometric signatures, passwords, PIN, etc. So with this, we have come to end of this topic of digital signature. Now in the next session, we will try to read something about intellectual property laws and information technologies, and afterwards we will look to broadcasts. Thank you.